Hello, I'm Kathy Cadjo. Welcome to my studio. Gather ye rosebuds while you may. The large painting in the middle is The Generous Gardener, which is the painting that's in the gold medal show. And that was put together actually in fall with a lot of roses blooming. And it was very moving to me because we had the fire the previous year and I didn't think I would have any garden. But everything came back, and that's all thanks to God for protecting this place. My house and studio survived the fire, which burned most of this neighborhood. Start with a white canvas, drawing on it with paint. I'm starting with a mixture of Radiant Red by Gamblin, Windsor Violet, and Williamsburg Still to Grain. And it makes this interesting mixture, and I'm thinning it with mineral spirits. And I'm just going to start drawing, blocking in big shapes, just like I started there. So I've set up this really beautiful floral still life. It's all roses from my garden. And it's October. And the amazing thing is there's such a proliferation of blooms right now. It's like spring. We had a difficult year in Malibu. And it seems that this fall, the garden is giving back double. It's trying to make up for what happened. So I'm going to paint this scene, and I'm going to call it after the main group of roses in here, which is called The Generous Gardener. And God is the real generous gardener because of what he gives to us. So when you take a rose and you put it out of water, you see this in paintings all the time, and I always wonder, gee, are they using fake roses? Because those are going to wilt and die really fast. So I have to paint them first. So I've gone ahead and decided my placement. And I'm going to go ahead and mix the color up and just paint it before I do any background or any other sketching, because those just aren't going to last. I arranged it so that what was in the pattern of the fabric enhanced and augmented
the dynamic lines that were already going through. So I had already started out with these roses on the table. So I arranged this peacock that his arching neck goes and flows into the line of the roses, because I wanted that shape to continue. And then that's fun thing is too, is the rest of these peacocks are over here. So you see this peacock, and that's this one. And then this guy whose head is hidden, but his head comes out over here. So I painted the whole peacock, but in two places. And I just did that again, the arching lines here, it echoes the shapes that are in the painting. So it takes your eye around, and you should just keep moving, and it should feel like music. It should feel like a dance. So all of my floral still life are done from roses from my garden that I selected and planted. And normally when I'm setting these up, I'll actually take quite a long time, maybe hours, to get the arrangement exactly how I want it. So this is where I might set it up. I use a backdrop. And these are paintings that I've done all from my garden. All the roses are from my garden. The north light window is what I use to paint from. Right now we have all the skylights open and lots of extra light that I normally don't have so that we can shoot the video. But when I'm working in here, it's almost exclusively from the north light window, which you see up high. We don't use the ones down below. And this is modeled after Sorolla's studio in Madrid. You see that the bottom of the window is still at least 8 feet from the ground, and that there's a step back there. Depending on how I arrange things, I can paint and step back in the alcove so I can see the painting from a distance and get a fresh eye and get some objectivity on it. But that's very important to have the high north light. It's a constant light, as constant as can be. Now you see we've got some sunlight and clouds, but we will have the most consistent light to paint from with a high north window. Not a skylight, but a high north face. And so this face is true north. So this is El Matador, a very popular spot. Wedding photographers, every kind of photographer is down there. It's a very busy place. It's a huge rock. A person can fit and walk through where you see that light. A person can walk under there, just tell you how big it is. So there's a certain time of the year and a certain time of the evening right before sunset when the sun comes around and it's hidden, it's blocked by the big rock there. And all of a sudden the light just boom, it just pops through and it's just blinding and it's amazing looking. And what it reminded me of was when Moses is talking to God and he says, "Show me your glory. I want to see your glory." And God says, "You cannot see me and live. My glory is too great for you. So I'll put you in the cleft of the rock and I will shield you so that you can perceive my glory from my backside as I pass by." So this to me was an analogy of Moses is put in the cleft of the rock. And we're able to perceive as much of that glory as we can without our eyeballs burning out because the rock blocks the direct sun staring right at us, but you still get the effect. And so this painting really ties into that scripture, and it's called Show Me Your Glory. Everything I do, yes I do. I go, she's on my mind. I would give the world my soul to discover. Here's my tabaret, paints. I have paint storage everywhere, actually. Lots of brushes, lots of paint. Everything's on casters, so I can move it around wherever I need to. Dream of no other.
out here in the deep.
All right, here we have the model stand. This is also on casters. We can hang any number of draperies behind it to change what the background looks like. And both the pieces move, so I can put it anywhere in the room. If I'm going to do a portrait workshop, we're going to work from the model, I can move it right to the center here. All these things move around. You can put easels around and work from the model. And also I can roll it all the way up here and put it in my wonderful Northlight window. And this is all my creative vision. The patios, the gardens, the arches, the tile. My inspiration was taken from Soroya's studio in Madrid, but also the Adamson house here in Malibu. So we have the tiles made similar to or exact duplicates of the tile. I also wanted to make a viewing deck so I can look across the gardens and look at this phenomenal view.